Hey everybody that doesn't know me, my name's Jordy Johnson at Carve and Fusion here. This is a piece of Western Red Cedar I found on the beach 2 weeks ago, so it would be known as driftwood. And I'm going to run through what carving burrs I use to create this and what carving tools I use to create this wood spirit. Hope you can enjoy the video and I hope it can have the chance to help you. Okay, you guys can see I got my face already drawn on here. There's already templates on my playlist, how to draw your wood spirit face. And if anybody wants to learn how to carve a wood spirit, I have a step-by-step in my playlist, how to carve a wood spirit. This isn't going to be a carving video. This is just going to be me showing you what type of burrs, different types of burrs I use when I'm making this carving. This is a Kutzall Extreme, okay? If you want to get a Kutzall burr, this is my favorite type of burr. Kutzall Flame Extreme Burr. Follow the link in the description below and use the code CFUSION to save yourself 5%. So I'm going to be doing all the bulk cutting with this burr, okay? And today I'm running, once again, my Dremel RTX. And it has a Dremel flex shaft. Yes, the Dremel flex shaft fits on this. Okay, this is a great, great, great rotary tool, people. They call me Heavy Hands, and I haven't broken this yet, and I've been running it strong for 2 months, and it's a workhorse. So I suggest this, and it's affordable. I suggest this to anybody looking to buy a rotary tool to pick up this sucker. Okay, so let me get carving here. What I'm going to do, I'm going to bulk out all the outside of the wood spirit. I'm going to cut on the outside of the lines and make everything raised and pop. And I'm going to make this, just start carving. Okay, guys, so everything's going on point with this. He's got a real slim face. At first, when I started carving this, I wanted to carve real eyes, but I think it's just too slim of a face, so I'm going to just cut holes underneath these eyes. I got this Kutzall Extreme Taper Burr on here now, so I'm going to cut underneath the eyes, not straight up and down, not right like that, but on basically a 45, okay? That will leave a nice hollow to give it blank eyes. So I've given this guy hair. Okay, also I forgot to mention that this is a piece of Western Red Cedar, guys. Okay, I've been having troubles with this piece of driftwood I found about a month ago, because there's lots of cracks in it. You can see the cracks all throughout it, but it's okay. You have to work your way around that kind of stuff, you know what I mean? Also, you can see here, I keep on repeating where it rides up, you can see the lip rides up the mustache. Let's see if we can give you a better shot of this. Well, I already see how it kind of rides up the mustache. So what I'm going to do is get this tapered burr and cut inside here like this. Separate the lip from the mustache so it doesn't look like it's riding up the side of it. Okay? And then I'm going to do this. I'm going to cut the eyes in. I'm going to do the lip with this. And then I believe I'm going to switch over to my aluminum cutting burr to put the beard hairs in. Another thing too, guys, I want to point out, see, this is a piece of driftwood. So when you get driftwood, look at this crack. This whole thing's cracked. I don't know if I'm going to be able to, let's see if I can break it right now. Oh, no, I'll break it. There you go. I didn't see that when I first started the piece. Okay. Now it's a lot smaller. It will save me money on shipping, because I'm sending this out to a good friend of mine. But you can see this crack goes all the way down here. I thought about carving it out, but I said I'm just going to leave it in. And it just gives it more character. That's all. We'll be right back. going on point. I got all the beard hairs cut in. I got the eyes cut in. I got the nostrils cut in. I got all the hairs cut in. You guys, if you don't know, this is what I use to cut the hairs in. It's an aluminum cutting burr. 1/8 in your Dremel flex shaft, okay? See, this is a cutter on both sides. You can get them that have cutters just on one side too. See, this is the same burr. Okay? Two of the same burrs right there. But look, this one has a cutter on the bottom. Zoom in. And this one doesn't. Okay? There you go. They both work good, guys. This one right here is less aggressive, but I use this one. This is a real soft piece of cedar. So, like I said, everything's going on point. I might give this just a quick little sanding right now with my flap sander, I'm not sure. But my next move is going to be the most boring part of the carving. And that is, I'm going to, because like I said, this is going to be a gift for someone, I am going to burn in each individual beard hair. So I'm going to go get that hooked up and I'll show you what I mean. Boring. But you guys, you know, some stuff's boring, but you know, like they say, the more time you put into a piece, the better it's going to look. I think anyways. On point. Okay, so I got my wood burner all hooked up. This is just one off Amazon. I think it was $50. This is cheapy. Called the home light. It works good. It heats up really fast, but this thing does get hot after lots of use. Okay, you have to put it down, turn it off, let it cool down. I got this little fan from one of those blow-up Christmas, outdoor Christmas things. You know, those, like mine was the Grinch, but it ripped. So I just took this fan out of it to blow the smoke away from me. So let's turn this on, watch how fast it gets hot. There, it's hot. I hammered this tip down to make it skinnier, as just Carve Rob suggested I do. I hammered it and sanded it. It's kind of a bit crooked right now. Oops. This is, like I said, this is the boring part. But after I put my stain on it, it will really make the piece better. So look how that smoke gets blown away from me too. So I'll be doing this for 50,000 hours. And I think I need to sandpaper that tip cleaner. The cleaner your tip is, the better it's gonna burn. But yeah, this is gonna take a while. So I'll get this done. You can do underneath the age lines, the eyebrows. I'm going to do this whole thing. Everything I need to do. Oh boy. I'm going to be here till tomorrow morning. Oh boy. Okay, I had to turn this off for a bit. I had to cool it down to rest. This only took 4 days to do so far. So yeah. On another point here, off carving subject, I had the weirdest dream last night. I don't know what's up with it, but I kept shitting my pants in my dream. Everywhere I went, I shit my pants. I just have no idea what that's about. No, I didn't wake up with a shit bed, but I don't know. Has anybody else had dreams where they kept on shitting their pants? Who knows? Okay, I had to put this down. It was getting hot again. But, man, all these beard hairs. I don't know what I was thinking, man. Whew. Maybe I was just wondering why I had that dream last night. Now I gotta do the hair. Yeah. Okay, it's slowly getting there. You guys, this is the stuff. I think this is what you want to use when you want to make like little animal hairs, like sheep. Like somebody just asked me on one of my comments. So this is what you would want to use to make like textured sheep hair or goat hair or I don't know, any kind of animal hair. I'd use this for sure, 100%, constant same texture. Okay guys, so all the beard hairs, this is what I hate the carving looks the most. I think it looks funny right now, but I got all the beard hairs and the hair hairs, the eyebrows, the mustache, everything's burnt in. You guys, you know, if you want to start doing this burning with the hairs and stuff like that to make it a more detailed, make sure you're committed. You know what I mean? This took me about, just for people's reference, this took me about, I'd say an hour and a half, 2 hours to do. And I'd say 2 hours to do this. And I had to put that handle down about four times from overheating, getting too hot for my hand. So anyways, so in the eyes, I always do this most of my wood spirits when I want to do a nice one. Under the eyes, the nostrils, and in the mouth there, I get some dollar store black paint. This is just water-based paint. I think it cost me $1. Dollar store brush. And no, I'm not going to sell this one. But I just paint inside the eyes, the nostril, the under the eyes, in the nostrils, and in the mouth, just to help advance, make it look darker for when I do the staining. And this is going to be poly shade, guys. Okay? And this color is Royal Walnut. It's just what I have around the house right now. So that's what I'm going to be using, because I don't mind this color anyways. So anyways, let me get under the eyes and stuff here painted. Okay guys, so I got the eyes in there, stuff painted in there, and the mouth, see how dark it is now? Now let's put some of this stuff on. So I'm going to finish this quickly. I'm going to put all this stuff on, okay? And then I'm going to wipe it down with the rag I got handy here. Okay, and then after I wipe it down, I'm going to use my flap sander. And I call it kind of like a buffer. I do it when this stuff's still wet. This is a poly, I think it's a polyurethane, guys. But I do it when this stuff's still kind of wet, because it kind of like smudges it. It's hard to explain, but it's like, it blends everything in together, and it makes it so you can really see the high points a lot better too. So anyways, I'll get this done. Sorry, I'll get this done, and then I'll wipe it, and then I'll show you what I mean with the sander. With my flap sander, you can see in my playlist how I make them, okay? Okay, guys, this is the little flap sander that I use. Look at my playlist. You'll see a single video in my playlist how to make these, okay? So this one's a bit worn out, but this is what I'm talking about. You'll see the natural color of the wood start to pop. And this kind of, this will be no good after I do it with this, because this stuff's, well, we'll just ruin this, but no big deal. I'm just do it real slow. Well, it's unplugged. This is not an old, this flex shaft. This flex shaft that I'm using here is an old Dremel flex shaft. It's the older style. You watch here. See it's starting to, how it's starting to make it blade again. See guys? See what's brighter there? Right there? That's from this and those eyebrows. Okay, so I'm gonna finish this and I'll show you what it's like. Okay guys, so here it is, pretty much well done. Just a simple piece of cedar driftwood, guys. See how that, see your highlights there? How that thing, like I said, it kind of acts as a buffer around the nostrils there, on the lip. I don't know if you guys can see those colors in there. But look how nice and smooth everything is now. It's still a little bit wet, but it's drying. You can see the highlights there now. So it just goes to show you all the time me spent burning sure gives this beard, mustache, eyebrows, up in here, I even burnt inside the age lines, how much it really helps your makes it look better. Long story short, more detailed. So like I said in the video, this carving was for a special gift for a special friend. All of you that don't know my channel, we got a pretty big community of different wood carvers with different types of carvings and on YouTube, and you know, I give them lots of shout outs. Just Carve Rob. This is your shout out, bud. This carving's for you, man. You know, how could you guys Just Carve Rob, check out his channel. Hey Rob, how can I let you carve Geordie with a spirit balloon and Oswald the Grouch and send it to me without sending you something back? Rob, you remember I found this piece of driftwood about 3 weeks ago on the beach in Tawasin, and I even sent you a video right when I found this piece, and I sent you the video of this piece. And you said, oh, you should carve an owl for in here. Well, Rob, that's what I'm hoping you'll do. You'll carve an owl to put in here. Put a little branch across here or something and carve one of your cool little owls. Put in there and it, keep the piece for yourself to remember me by. You know, because I don't know if I'm going to be here tomorrow, or I don't know when my time's going to be up. So I sent you a wood spirit before, but that one was a piece of shit one. You know, I wanted you to have one where I spent a lot of time on and something that you can be really proud of. So, and another thing too, Rob, you also said in one of your videos that you were thinking about getting one of those, you know, those heat branding things, because I see on the back of your carvings, you burn your stuff in, okay? So I did this for you too, to Rob, from Geordie. Sign your pieces, people. I burnt this in just for you, Rob. I just carve it in. But also, Rob, you know, so that metal branding stuff that you're talking about, look at this. Who already has one, buddy? Who already has one? Carving Fusion, bud. You get the branded spirit, Rob. It'll be in the mail when it dries off. Can't wait to see what you're going to do with the owl or whatever you want to put in there. I don't know. You can even carve a pig. Put a pig in there. Do what you want. Hope everybody's great. And we'll see you later. Hope this video's helped somebody. See you later.